So after covering up the commenting mechanism in our app, let's consider the other functions. This function returns the list of comments, and this function is to add the comment. It adds the comment to the recipe ID passed and by whom the comment is been given. So this function, it's been implemented in the repo, and the functions that are defined in the repo are been reused elsewhere. So these are the reused functions. Now the important part of adding the reaction, as in the previous video we had discussed about the nesting of reaction. Here the process of adding a reaction should also be compatible with that mechanism. So here what happens is that first the client should send the parent reaction ID. Means if the reaction is not a child reaction, then it will be null, and these are all the necessary other IDs. So if the parent reaction ID is not null, it means it is a child reaction. So first we need to fetch the parent reaction, and then we need to save the newly created child reaction into the reactions field of the parent reaction, and then save the parent reaction. By this, what happens is that the reaction object will have a sub list of reactions. So this one method is enough to create a nesting of reactions, and the utmost means the topmost parent reaction will have the comment ID. So that will be linked to the comment. So that's all about the comment controller. Next video will be about the user controller.